Good morning. Pastor Sean here on Thursday, February 4th, with your morning prayer to start your day. So let's get right into it. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall declare your praise. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia. Give glory to God, our light and our life. O come, let us worship him. O come, let us sing to the Lord, let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving, let us make a joyful noise to him with songs of praise. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the depths of the earth, the heights of the mountains are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hand formed the dry land. O come, let us worship and bow down, let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Give glory to God, our light and our life. O come, let us worship him. Our text for today, and we're opening up the Gospel of John, and so we're going to have a lot of fun with that. John chapter 1, verses 1 through 18. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness, to bear witness about the light, that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but came to bear witness about the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own people did not receive him. But to all who did receive him, who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth. John bore witness about him and cried out, "This was he of whom I said, He who comes after me ranks before me, because he was before me. And from his fullness we have all received grace upon grace. For the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. The only God who is at the Father's side, he has made him known." In many and various ways, God spoke to his people of old by the prophets, but now in these last days he's spoken to us by his Son. Well then, where do we start? I'm going to try to keep this brief, even though, I mean, just this little introductory part. I mean, you could spend so much time pulling all sorts of just wonderful, wonderful things from this. I think the biggest, I mean, the most kind of mind-blowing sort of thing is just the first few verses where in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. The Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. Jesus Christ is the Word. You know, and in 14, the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. So this is, I mean, just right there. Jesus is the Word of God. Is, I mean, weeks-long Bible studies can be filled with just that. And it's the cool thing is just take that. And then in your own personal devotions and your own reading, whatever, go through the Old Testament. You know, if you're making your way through the Old Testament now, awesome. But just, you know, pick your favorite book, I don't know, or favorite section, whatever, and read through it. And basically anywhere that God speaks, anytime God interacts, and he always does by speaking through either just speaking or speaking through like a burning bush, through a cloud, a pillar of fire, whatever. That is God speak. That's Jesus. you know, if you've ever wondered, well, where was Jesus in the Old Testament times? I mean, he was with God in the beginning. Okay. And then he shows up in Bethlehem. Where was he that entire time? It's like, well, he was all over the place. I mean, the Bible is the Word of God. So the Bible is God speaking through the prophets writing down God's word. That is literally Jesus on the pages coming through to us. So, I mean, he's on every page of the Old Testament, but in a, you know, looking at it as a narrative sense, anytime God is speaking to his people, that's Jesus. He speaks through Jesus because the thing, nobody has ever seen God. And you know, nobody can be in the presence of God because they would die. You know, and any time God interacted with his people in the Old Testament, he had to be veiled. He had to be obstructed. The view had to be obstructed between the people and him. Nobody could stand in the presence of God. Even, you know, when Moses would go in, he'd have to veil his face. He'd have a covering. Something always had to mask God from his people. And Jesus is that mask. Jesus is that covering. God wraps himself in the flesh, in Jesus Christ, and that is how he comes to us, to have the ability to for us not to just, you know, in the presence of God. And so that word is God sending Jesus to us so that way he can speak to us, so that he can be with us, so that his holiness can be in our lives, even though we are completely sinful and unclean. And it's just awesome stuff. And so it makes so much sense. So he was in the beginning with God. So God, Jesus, right from the beginning, all things were made through him. So, you know, we confess that God the Father is the creator of heaven and earth. God, you know, the first article of the creed is God as creator. He creates all things. He provides all things. It's all the stuff that God provides for us. The second article of the creed, Jesus, is our salvation, how God saves us, okay, through Jesus Christ. Then the third article, Holy Spirit, how we are brought into that salvation, sanctification, all that good stuff. But, you know, they all work together in all these things. So Jesus had a key part in creation because he is God. Right? God created the heavens and the earth. Therefore, God the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, all involved. But how does God create? You know, you go back to Genesis. He speaks. He says, let there be light. And there's light. He speaks, let there be, you know, this. Boom, 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 boom. Well, Jesus is the Word. Jesus is God's speaking. And so when we read, let there be light, he's creating through his word. He's speaking his word, creating through Jesus Christ. So, I mean, that's great stuff anyway. But then you go through and you start reading through the Old Testament and you see like, okay, Moses in the burning bush. Okay. All right. That's Jesus. That's Jesus right there. You know, God is coming to his man, Moses. He's speaking to him, and he's in this, you know, he's using the burning bush as kind of the medium through which he speaks, but his speaking is through Jesus Christ. And so we can see that in that this is Jesus coming to Moses, as this is God coming to Moses, therefore speaking through Jesus. So that's Jesus in the Old Testament. Anywhere you see God speaking to his people, that's through Jesus Christ. And so and it's just a fascinating thing then, if you go through and read the Old Testament with that understanding, it's just crazy because Jesus is all over the place. And then it's really cool because now you see how Jesus comes through, and he's always been with his people, bearing with them from the very beginning, which then makes, you know, you look at all the history of the Old Testament and to the culmination of the cross and just, I mean, we definitely, on a personal level, you know, on Good Friday, we look up and see the crucifix, and we know our sin put him there. It's very emotional. It's very, connects us, whatever. But now reading through, you know, just so many generations and generations of God's beloved people who turned away from him, who rejected him, who just fell into abject sin. And still, Jesus comes to us, the Word becomes flesh, to die for all people. You know, us included, of course. But it just kind of makes it, wow, heavy-duty stuff. But just that right there, that Jesus is the Word of God. He's been with God since the beginning. God speaks through Jesus. That is his Word coming to us. Changes the way you hear Scripture, especially the Old Testament, in the most awesome way. And so I would encourage you to just pull some Old Testament out today and read through it, you know, where God speaks, and see how Jesus is there. God is speaking through Jesus, and I guarantee you'll probably get something out of that you've never really gotten before. Yeah, good stuff. All right. Much more to say about that, but we got to keep it within our little time frame here. So let us pray. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, almighty and everlasting God, you've safely brought us the beginning of this day. Defend us in the same with your mighty power, and grant that this day we fall into no sin, neither run into any kind of danger, but that all of our doings, being ordered by your governance, may be righteous in your sight. through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now, taught by our Lord and trusting in his promises, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Well, let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Almighty and merciful Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless and preserve you. Amen. Well, thank you for joining me today for receiving the Word of God, receiving Jesus Christ through the Word, which again, cool stuff. So I hope this is a blessing to you today and truly adds a lot to your devotion. So until tomorrow, peace be with you. Mm-hmm.